Hey everyone, welcome to Apigee Edge 4-Minute Videos for Developers, Season 25, Episode 3. In this episode, we're going to see how to dynamically cache the API data based on cache keys using Apigee API Management Platform. Myself, Anil Sagar, I work at Google on Apigee platform. Prerequisites for this video, you need to understand the basics of API caching. For that, you can refer earlier 4-Minute video. Let's say you are using Apigee Edge API Management Platform that is sitting in between the client and the target system. Whenever you create an API proxy and implement the response cache policy, you can able to cache the data in Apigee Edge platform so that whenever the API request comes in, Apigee can able to serve the data directly without going all the way to the backend systems. Most of the time, you would like to cache the data based on some dynamic conditions so that you can able to cache the data based on the key and values so that you can able to dynamically reference to this data whenever API call comes to Apigee Edge platform. Let's see how to construct these cache keys dynamically based on the request variables. We're going to create a simple API proxy to demonstrate this. I'm going to name the proxy as dynamic cache and give the proxy base path as /v1/mock API and give the existing API as http://httpbin.org. Click on next, choose authorization as pass through. Click on next, choose defaults, build and deploy. Once API proxy is created, click on the proxy to access the develop screen and let's add the response cache policy to enable the API caching. Click on develop, click on preflow, click on plus step, add the response cache policy. As you can see, by default, the cache policy is caching the data based on the URI. Sometimes it can be headers so that you can able to dynamically cache the data. Let's see it in action. What is the key fragment and why we need to dynamically construct these cache keys to identify the response data uniquely. Let's click on trace and start the trace session. We're going to make an API call to this particular endpoint, mock API, and then /get. As you can see, I'm sending headers partner ID 100, name is equal to null. When I make the first call, as you can see, it is going all the way to the backend. When I make the second call, and it is getting returned from the cache data. As you can see, it is returned from the cache data. Let's say you change the headers from partner ID 100 to partner ID 200 and Anil to Sagar. Ideally, you expect the partner ID and name in the response also 200 and Sagar. Let's say you make the API call, you still see Anil and 100 because the data is cached based on the request URI. But we would like to also consider the headers when caching the data. Let's see how to do that using cache keys. So I go back to the develop screen, click on response cache. We're going to append the key fragment with two more parameters. Request.header.partnerID and request.header.name. As you can see, partnerID and name are the variables. Let's save the API proxy and then see it in action. Now the key is constructed based on the URI, based on the partnerID, and based on the name. Click on trace, start trace session. Now let's make an API call and see the responses in action. So first we're going to make an API call with partner ID 200 and name Sagar. As you can see, Sagar and 200. And if you make one more call, then again, you're getting the cache data, which says partner ID 200 and name Sagar. As you can see, it is cache data. Let's say if we change the ID 300 and let's say Anil Sagar, then again, it goes all the way to the backend because we changed the cache keys. As you can see, Anil Sagar and 300. And the API call is going all the way to the backend because the cache key is dynamically constructed based on the headers this time. As you can see, the cache key is request URI followed by the partner ID and the name. That's the advantage of cache keys, where you can able to construct these keys dynamically and cache the data based on different request variables. Thank you for watching this video. If you are evaluating Apigee, you can reach out to us using this link. If you have any questions, please feel free to post your questions in comi.apigee.com. Please spread the love for APIs by sharing this video with your friends and colleagues and subscribe to YouTube channel to get notified if any future videos.